Assalamualaikum, good afternoon, boleh dengar?
Waalaikumsalam, boleh dengar, Prof.
Right, so we continue with chapter 5B, which is the interactive demo of IDEM using MATLAB for the hot air blower system. So our objective actually is to estimate and validate the linear models from a single input output data or SISO to find the best model to represent the hot air blower system dynamics. So we are going to using MATLAB with the function IDENT, IDENT, okay, with the data dryer2.mat, yeah, which will include samples of 1,000 input and 1,000 output. So what we do is we just type the load dryer2 at the MATLAB command line, then we can access for U2 and Y2, which is accompanied in the MATLAB software. This is a real data from an actual hair dryer and has been cited in Leonard Jung book, in System Identification textbook, where U2 is the input and Y2 is the output. And this is the schematic that I just described in chapter 5A, where the process begins with the sucking of air at the input and then goes to the fan and goes to the heater mesh wire, and the flow of air will be in the tube to the right, okay, and before it exits at the output, the temperature of the air will be measured by thermistor. Okay, the black one is thermistor, and thermistor will send the signal to the controller for the hot air blower control system. So this is the trainer, okay, the real trainer that we obtain the data. So it the process is as follow, as I mentioned to you: air fan through a tube and heated at the inlet. The air temperature is measured by a thermocouple or thermistor. So we are using thermistor. The input U is the power in watt over the heating device, which is just a mesh of resistor wire. And the output is the air temperature, okay, which is measured by the thermistor. And in this demo, okay, U2 is the input, okay, and Y2 is the output. Then we type the IDEN. So it will give you this kind of box. We call it as GUI, or GUI, Graphic User Interface, okay, in MATLAB, where we import the data of the hot air blower. Then we pre-process the data. Then we estimate the model. And then we see the what is the mathematical model on the left box here. I will show you later, okay, but let me finish the slide first. So we import the data, and our data is a time domain data, okay. So we put the input and output in the workspace variable here, okay, and then put the starting time at zero, and sampling interval is 80 milliseconds. But this user interface can only accept seconds, so you have to type 0.08, that is equivalent to 80 milliseconds. And then you can see the input and output plotting, okay. So the sampling interval 80 milliseconds, sampling frequency is 1 over 0.08, which is 12.5 hertz. Then you put the name of data as dry, the raw data. Okay, the input is in watt, the output is in Celsius, degree Celsius. Then you import the data, then you get the data over here, which is dry. Okay, so click at the time plot to see the data plotting. There you go, the data plotting. Okay, this is the raw data. So you can see that it's not start from zero at the input and the output. So we need to do the pre-processing to remove the DC offset. Okay. See, it's not start from zero. Okay, so from the data observed, it is observed that the DC offset exists in the data input output. So we need to remove this because it will disturb and give a wrong information in our best fit validations. Okay, so pre-processing will remove the constant level in the data sequence and remove the means. Okay, so what happened is the green one is better than the blue one. The blue one is the raw data. The green one is the data after pre-process, where you remove the DC offsets. Okay, you can see that the blue and the green is the same data, but the green is after pre-processing, after we clean up the data, input and output. Okay, so then we use this pre-processed data, we drag and drop, okay, into the working data here. Okay, we drag and drop, we click at the dry D, and then we drop here. Okay, and after that we have to do the pre-processing again for select range data. Select range data is we divide data into two. The first half of the data is for the estimations, and the remaining half data is for the validations. So since our data length is 1,000 samples, so the first 500 for estimation and the remaining 500 for validations. Okay, so we did that in the select range under pre-process. Okay, so we got the first 500. Okay, then we insert, then the remaining 500. Okay, we put in the validations. Okay, so I repeat again, the blue one is raw data before pre-processing. The green data is data after pre-processing, which is after remove means DC offset. Then the red data is data that from the green data, okay, where we divide into two. This is the first 500 for estimation and the remaining 500 for validation. Okay, as I mentioned here. So now you drag and drop, okay, for the estimation 500 data, you drag and drop into the working data. And then the turquoise color here for validation data, you drag and drop to the validation data. Okay, and then you estimate. Okay, so the estimation is here. Okay, so the estimation is here. So we are using a step response for a while, meaning that for non-parametric, we test. Okay. So we get something like this. So it is about first or second order system response behavior. Okay, and then we see the spectral. Okay, the frequency response. Okay, and then we start to estimate the parametric models from this data. Okay, so you have to choose the from the estimation menu, the parametric models. Okay, so we have an ARX, autoregressive exogenous input. So we begin with the 441. Okay, 441 meaning ARX model, 4 poles, 4 minus 1, 3 zeros. Okay, and 1 delay. 441 meaning the first 4 is 4 poles, the second 4 is 4 minus 1, meaning 3 zeros, and the last 1 is time delay. Okay, so ARX 441, then we press the estimate. Okay, so it will give you ARX 441 model over here, And if you click double click at the 441, it will give you the A polynomials and the B polynomials. So the ARX 441 parametric model is equal to polynomial B divided by polynomial A, right? And then you plot the model input output. You can see that there is three lines here. The black line is the real data. The red line is the ARX 441. And the blue line is impulse response. So it seems that ARX 441 give a better reading, 89.61%. Okay. So this is, you can see that the estimated model try to follow the real data. Okay, measured and simulated. Measured meaning the black one is the real data measured from the experiment using sensor. And simulated data is the red color, which is the estimated model, ARX 441, estimated parametric model. Then we try another model, which is ARX 3, NK is equal to 3, B is equal to 2, and NA is equal to 2. Okay. We step the estimate computer, so it's a 2, 2, 3. Okay, ARX 2, 2, 3, meaning the first two is two poles, the second two is 2 minus 1, 1 zeros, and 3 is the time delay. Okay. Then it will give you double click at 2, 2, 3, it will give you the polynomial B and polynomial A. So the ARX 2, 2, 3 parametric model is equal to Y divided by U is equal to polynomial B divided by polynomial A. And if you plot it, okay, so this is the plotting for ARX 2, 2, 3. Okay, it gives you 89.18% best fit. Okay. And we see the response here. So the behavior is about first or second order system, as I told you before, in the data taken from the trainer. The trainer have two configuration. Is if it's open loop, it will give you a first order system. And if it's a closed loop, it will give you a second order model structure. So we compare. We analyze the three ARX model, which is 441, 331, and 223. Okay, 441 stands for four poles, 3 zeros, 1 delay. 331 stands for 3 poles, 2 zeros, 1 delay. 223 stands for 2 poles, 1 zeros, 3 time delays. Okay, we do the simulations. The black line is the real data, and the blue line is the estimated ARX 441 data. Okay, estimated or simulated. Okay, is the same. Give you 89.61%. And the model is, the detail of the polynomials is here. You have to double click the icon of 441. Then you import it. Okay, you write it properly here, Y divided by U is equal to the B divided by A. So this is B polynomials from the MATLAB calculations. Okay, so you can see that this one, the numerator can be factorized. Can be factorized. I will show you in the next slide. And polynomial A is 1 minus 1.125 until Z power of minus 4, meaning that you have a 4 poles. So this is the ARX model. So the numerator we factorize 0.001272 Z minus 1 multiplied by 1 plus 2.4 plus 49 plus 42. Okay. B can be factorized. That's why this one 0.0012 1272 will give you can be cancelled out because this one will equal to zero. So you have a 3 zeros and 4 poles. Okay. If you equal the numerator to zero and denominator to zero. Okay, you can factorize this one become 3 zeros and 4 poles. So the corresponding zeros value is by using a calculator. Okay, so this one you must be able in the bracket, you must be able to use calculator to find the zeros value. So zeros value have two complex conjugate zeros, minus 0.766 plus minus J6.9 and minus 0.8. For poles, you have a 4, so you have to key in these coefficients inside your calculator. Okay, so for your information, calculator, the new calculator with the white casing can give roots until power of 4. Okay, the old calculator only can give you roots of 3 maximum, but the new calculator with the white casing can give you until 4 roots. Okay, can be factorized power of 4. Okay, so better you buy the white color because you are doing masters for the second semester and the third semester as well. Okay, so when you plot the poles and zero mapping, this one, the circles is the unit circles. Okay, so you have 3 zeros and 4 poles. See, one, this one is together, and this one, so 4 poles and 3 zeros. Then the other analysis is the correlation analysis. And the frequency response, the step response, and power spectrum is associated with the results of the models. Can be print and can be analyzed. Then we move to 331. 331 give you 88.86% best fit. Okay, the estimated model fit the data with the best fit of 88.86. Ideal is 100%. Okay, but impossible to get ideal from the experiment. And the 441 model, that's right, the 331 model, okay, the title is wrong, it's 331, it's not 441. It's given here, polynomial A and polynomial B. So you import it, then you get the transfer function here. Numerator and denominator. Numerator can be factorized. Okay, when you factorize, you get two zeros value, two complex conjugate zeros, which is minus 0.4 plus minus J6.07, and 3 poles. Okay, because the highest is 3, so P1, P2, and P3. Okay, so when you plot into the complex conjugate poles, you get here. 3 poles and 2 zeros. So what do you understand from here? The system is stable. Why? All poles in the transfer function is inside the unit circles. Okay. But there are 2 zeros outside unit circles, meaning that the system is non-minimum phase. Okay. Non-minimum phase. So if all zeros inside unit circles, so the system is not non-minimum phase anymore, but we call it as a minimum phase and stable. Okay, so stable because all poles inside the unit circle. And the corresponding other non-parametric analysis, okay, support the parametric models. And the last one is 223. Give you 89.18%, okay, best fit, and the model is here, Y over U, ARX 223, which can be factorized as follow, So 1, 0 and two poles, the zeros is -0.689, poles is 0.743 and 0.535. So you can see that now zeros inside in a circle, three poles inside in a circle. So the system is stable, eh? Stable and minimum phase. And the analysis of non-parametric system to support the 2-3 model. So you compare together, three graph together. So you can see that which one give you the best one is the 3-3-1, eh? 3-3-1, eh, sorry, 3, not 3-3-1, 4-4-1, okay? Which give you 89.61. You can try this data when I demo to you. Try to get 100% or maybe above 90%, okay, using several model structure. Okay, so this is the mapping for all three models together. Okay, but if you don't have any idea of the model structure, computer and MATLAB will help you by clicking a quick start. So you can the computer and MATLAB will suggest for you the best model. Okay, in this case is impulse, N4S3 is the state space, and the ARXQS. Okay. Okay, let's go to the MATLAB. Okay, so everybody please listen carefully. Okay, so I opening my MATLAB now. Nampak tak? Can you see the MATLAB? Hello?
Yes, Doctor. Yes, boleh.
Nampak, eh? So, first we load the data. LOAD load. Dryer 2. Okay? Because data dryer 2 is in MATLAB software. So, now they read the data based on the workspace, eh? You tengok dekat sebelah kiri tu ada workspace. U2 and Y2. Apa tu? 1,000 by 1, 1,000 by 1. Apa maksud dia? Maksudnya adalah, dia adalah vektor. Eh? 1,000 baris, satu kolom. 1,000 rows and one column. Okay? Jadi kita type U2. Apa dapat keluar? Itu dia data dia. Okay? Then kita tengok plot. Data tu. Plot U2. Nampak tak data tu? Tak nampak? Nampak tak? Tak nampak, eh?
Yang mana ni, Doktor, tak nampak.
Ni. Nampak? Nampak? Nampak?
Nampak.
Okay. So, 1,000 data. PRBS ni, 1,000. Okay, random boundary sequence. Then, we move to the apa nama ni yang MATLAB tadi tu, Y2 kita enter, dan kita lihat dia punya plotting Y2. Okay, Y2 dekat sini. Nampak? Y2. Ada beza tak?
Nampak.
Ni output. Yang tadi tu input. 1,000, eh. Jadi you can play around, nak plot the first 100 boleh, first 300 boleh, first 700 pun boleh. Guna command dalam chapter 5A tadi. Okay. So now we use the toolbox. Okay. Toolboxnya adalah kita type ident lah. IDENT. Okay. Ident. So ignore the red color. Right. Then you will see the GUI box as shown here. But
okay.
Okay, clear eh? Tengah nafas sekejap. Okay, dah keluar ni. Kemudian kita buat business. Import, import, export. Import dulu, import data. Ini kan, time domain data. Okay, so dia akan keluar satu Windows ini. Okay, nampak tak Windows tu? Tak nampak? Jadi saya kena bagi nampak. Nampak?
Okay, nampak.
Kemudian input. Input tadi apa? U2 kan? U2. Outputnya adalah Y2. Okay, so name of data. Kita pakai dry lah eh. Dry. Kering. DRY. Okay. Starting time, 0. Sample time, 80 millisecond. 80 millisecond dalam second adalah 0.08. Okay. Then kita tekan more. Kita letaklah input ni sebagai power kan. Power. Then outputnya adalah temperature. Okay. And the input is watt. Okay. And the output is degree Celsius. Eh? Celsius. Unit dia. Then we import. Press import here. Okay. Oops. Tekan dua kali pula. Padahal benda sama kan? Oops. Okay. Benda sama. Jadi apa yang kita buat, kalau kita tersilap, kita ambil ni, drag and drop ke tong sampah. Trash. Ha, nampak tak tong sampah tu? Daripada slim jadi gemuk. Nampak tak?
Ini nampak, Prof.
Kita buang tadi data tu yang hijau tu sebab kita saya tekan dua kali. Jadi yang raw data ni adalah kita tengok time plot dia. Okay. Tengok time plot dia. There you go. Time plotnya. Together. Output and input together. Sama lah macam yang tadi tu kan. So Fariha. Fariha mana? Hello Fariha. Ego.
Yes, Doktor.
Apa observation awak pada data ni? Your observation please.
Kalau tengok kat sini, graph output yang temperature ni, dia try follow input.
Okay.
And then.
Okay, apa lagi? Saya bagi tip sikit. Saya bagi tip. Okay. Apa yang berlaku kat sini?
Dia tak start daripada.
Dia tak start daripada?
Kosong.
Dia tak start daripada kosong lah. Kita punya datum line, reference line kita kan. Jadi apa kita kena buat adalah kita kena. Kena apa?
Itu simulation, buang mean dia.
Simulation, pre-processing. Macam beli ikan kan. Kita beli ikan, katalah ikan jenaha. Satu ekor, sekilo RM30. Jadi kita kena siang ikan tu. Kita kena buang sisik dia, kita kena buang insang dia, kita kena buang perut dia, unnecessary kan. Dah bersih, barulah kita boleh letak limau ke, asam jawa ke kan. Bersihkan bau dia semua, baru boleh goreng dan letak sos tiga rasa. Ini contoh eh, nak masak kan. Data pun sama juga. So kita kena pre-processing. Okay, so pre-processing maknanya kita kena remove. Remove apa? Remove means.
Means.
Okay, so kita remove means. So automatically data tu menjadi kosong eh. Mula pada kosong. Nampak? Nampak eh? Oh ni awak kena share. Jadi tak nampak. Tu dia. Biru terang dengan biru gelap. Okay. Biru gelap tu adalah yang remove means eh. Right, so and then we go back to the GUI. So the next step is kita drag and drop data tadi ni ke dalam working data. Sebab sekarang ni kita pakai data yang telah dibuang means offset. Dan seterusnya preprocessingnya adalah kita kena bagi dua select range. Okey. Kita kena select range. Okey. So time span tu jangan usik. Jadi kita ada 1000 data, nampak? Jadi kita bagi dua. 501, 1 sampai 501 is the first 500 kan? Jadi dia gunakan untuk E. E tu maknanya estimate. D tu maknanya dia buang offset tadi tu kan? Offset. Okay. Jadi yang first 500 dah jadi merah. Okay. The first 500 dah jadi merah pada plotting. Nampak? Okay. So tinggal yang remaining. Yang tu pula. Okay, remaining dia ialah kita buat macam ni, kita ni 1000 dan samples ni adalah 501. Okay, so dia jadi V. V tu maknanya validation. So kita insert. Okay, jadi bila kita insert, dia akan jadi plottingnya akan jadi warna turquoise. Okay, the red is the first 500, the turquoise is the remaining 500, total 1000. Right, lepas tu apa yang kita buat adalah working data ni kita kena gantikan lah. Instead of 1000 tadi kita letak dry estimate tu tadi yang 500, the first 500 masuk situ. Okay, and then drive V, validate the remaining 500 masuk dekat validation data. Jadi dua tu, working data dengan validation data. Working data is for estimation. Okay, validation data is for the, nak tengok validate betul tak data ni. Sebab tu data ni kena panjang. 10 data tak cukup. Untuk exam test bolehlah. Data 4, 5 okeylah. Sebab nak buat untuk exam kan. Tapi untuk betul-betul real punya analysis kena ribuan-ribuan data. Okay. Excuse me. Then we estimate. Okay. The estimate. Di sini. Okay. So kita nak pakai apa? Jadi banyak model di sini. Transfer function model, state space model, process model, polynomial models, non-linear model, spectral model, correlation model, refining existing model atau quick start. Quick start ni komputer yang cari kan. Okay. So kita pakai polynomial models lah sebab kita pakai ARX kan. Okay. So come you go. 441. 441 tu maknanya apa? ARX 441. 4 poles, 3 zeros and 1 time delay. Okay. Then we estimate. Dia main tekan aja. Jadi semua calculation dia buat. Ini memudahkan kita Kat sini ya, awak tak nampak agaknya. Kat sini. Bila awak tekan estimate tu, dia jadi macam ni. 441. 4 poles, 3 zeros and 1 time delay. Press the estimate. Okay, you press estimate. Nanti dia akan keluar dekat GUI tu 441. Nampak? Then model output. There you go. You dapat 89.61. Okay. Model outputnya. Ya. Yeah. Nampak? Nampak tak?
Nampak bro.
Saya tanya Daniel. Bro Daniel. Daniel?
Yeah, Prof. Yeah.
Can you comment on this, please? A few words. Tahu tak apa, salah tak apa, dia betul kan?
Excuse me. So the blue line and the black line, the blue line is trying to the blue line is trying to follow the black line, which is
What is blue line? What is black line?
The blue line is the predicted, and the white line is and black line, or the other way around?
The black line is the real data.
The real data, yes.
From data, from experiment.
Yes.
Which known as measured. Apa tak? The place to measured.
Yeah.
Pengukuran kan? Yang yes. Blue tu?
Is the predicted, the simulated. Yeah.
Is the estimated.
Estimated.
Okay. Estimated lah. Sedap sikit bunyi kan? Estimated. Hmm. Estimated data, okay. Model, ARX.
441.
441
tu apa?
four poles. The first four poles.
Okay.
The middle four is 4 minus 1. Jadi 3 zeros. One okay. Yang akhir itu adalah time delay. Lagi observation apa lagi? Best fit dia berapa?
Sorry?
Best fit.
Best fit.
Percentage dia berapa?
39.61.
Mana dapat? Ada tertulis kat situ. 89.61. Okay. So now we are going to see the real transfer function lah. Macam mana nak cari? Umar? The ARX 441 transfer function. Kat mana kita nak cari? Daripada GUI ini?
Yang kat bawah tu
Kat bawah? Bawah mana bang? Double click 441 ni. Double click.
Double click.
Okay. So double click, dia akan berikan awak satu window. Okay. Which is window ni. Nampak tak?
Nampak.
So ARX 441. Model A is a polynomial A and polynomial B. Jadi ARX 441 tu is equal to polynomial B divided by polynomial A. Okay. Jadi ambil yang ni lah. Copy paste masuk dalam awak punya report kalau awak pakai assignment nanti. Tapi assignment awak is second order kan?
Yep.
Jadi dia pakai ARX 221, 223 pun boleh. 221 lah. Sebab dia tak ada time delay. Dia RLC je. Okay. So, kat bawah dia kalau awak browse ni. Bawah B ni awak browse. Nampak tak dia bergerak tu? Dia ada bagi FPE dengan MSE. FPE tu maknanya final prediction error 0.001677. Maknanya dia almost zero. MSE mean squared error 0.001598. Maknanya very small lah. FPE, MSE very small. So maknanya the validation based on FPE and MSE very small error. And best fit is 89.61, maknanya the model is accepted lah. Yeah? Accepted and agreed with the real data. Boleh? InsyaAllah boleh.
Boleh, bro.
Untuk assignment nanti. Lagi seminggu. Kemudian kita estimate tadi apa? 441. Fariha. Jadi 441. Lagi apa lagi satu? 3. Lupa saya.
331
confirm
ya
yeah. Okey, jadi kita balik semula kepada polynomial models tadi. Okey, kita tukar kepada 331 331. Okey, dan kita klik pada sini, so automatic dia jadi 331 kat situ. Dan kita estimate
tak nampak bro.
Sorry, tak nampak Alamak, tak maaf Dia banyak window ni, nak kena share, pening saya. Okay. Tu, sorry. 331 Nampak? 331.
Nampak.
X. IV ni kita tak pakai. IV ni adalah instrumental variable. Saya tak pakai yang ni lah. Data is discrete. So, 331. Then, the estimate. So kita akan dapat dia punya GUI dia kat sini, sebelah dia, sebelah 441 ni, nampak? 331 ni hijau,
nampak?
Okay, so kita ada dua sekarang, So kalau kita tak kalau dia bold macam ni, maknanya dia activate. Kalau kita tekan ni, dia tak bold. Maknanya kalau dia tak bold tu, maknanya dia adalah not activate. Okay. Jadi kalau kita plotting pun, kita akan nampak satu je lah, hijau. Okay. Kita nampak hijau dengan hitam sahaja. Macam ni. Okay. Jadi kita minta brother Sivananta. Sivananta dia.
Ya, sudah.
Ya, comment sikit Sivananta. Can you give a few words?
The measured is in
measured is black. Measured is black line.
Yes.
Okay, estimated is
following the estimate, estimated output.
Yeah, estimated is the green line. All right?
Yes, correct.
Okay. How is the performance best fits in percentage?
88.86%.
Less than the 441, okay?
Yes, correct.
But if you round up, it's 89% lah actually, kan?
But it's still less than 90% lah.
Tapi okay lah, macam kalau macam exam, dapat markah 89%. Dapatlah A, kan? UTM ni sistem dapat A. Tapi kalau dapat 90, maknanya tu dah bukan A lagi, dia jadi A+.
Alright.
Maknanya grade dapat A+. Tetapi weighted dia tetap sama for flat. A and A+, weighted dia tetap sama 4.0. Cuma transkrip tu nampak cantik sikit lah, A+, kan? Right. So how to get the Sivananta, how to get the mathematical model from the ARX 331 ni?
Mathematical
model ni, dia punya transfer function ni. Double click.
By double click the ARX 331.
Okay, double click. So dia akan keluar ke situ. Okay. There you go. Nampak?
Okay, this is the mathematical.
This is the mathematical model. The details lah. The numerical. Okay. The numerical. Previously is the graph to show the best fit, kan?
So this is the mathematical model.
This is the detailed mathematical model. So you have a polynomial A and polynomial B. So ARX 331 is equal to Y divided by U, output divided by input equal to polynomial B divided by polynomial A. And check the validations by browsing. Kita turunkan bawah sikit. So kita nampak tak situ? FPE dengan MSE. Almost zero, kan?
Yes.
So kalau almost zero, maknanya dia adalah diterimalah sebab errornya zero. Okay. So seterusnya adalah kita try model yang satu lagi apa, Fariha? The last model yang kita tu.
The last one is ARX 223.
223. So kita pergi pada estimate. Kita pergi pada polynomial models. Okay. Okay, so kita pilih 223. 223. Okay. 223. Okay. So kita klik kat name, dia jadi 223. Okay. Nampak? Ni yeah, the estimate. Okay, so kita estimate, so dia akan keluar macam ni. Ah, tu dia 223, nampak? 223, kan? So 223 is a apa nama ni, panggil seorang student. Zul Atfi. Zul.
Ya, datang.
Boleh cerita sikit tak apa tu ARX 223?
two zeros.
Salah.
Two minus poles.
One poles.
Sorry, two poles. Two poles, waktu two minus one zero, satu lah. So, tiga time delay.
Tiga time delay. Okay, so kita nak tengok model output dia. Tunggu Zul, tunggu. Okay. Zul, komen sikit Zul. Model output dia.
Model output dia measure value, warna merah. So hitam tu adalah estimated value. So dia
terbalik.
Oh sorry. Hitam
is the value. Kau tengok merah ni. ARX 223 ni merah kan?
Merah.
Maknanya merah so, tu dia mewakili line merah yang estimate.
Estimate value dia merah. So hitam adalah measure value. So hampir serupa nak dekat-dekat sama.
Dia follow pada best speed
89.03.
Dia tak sama, dia mengikut lah. Dia mengikut.
Hampir. Sorry.
Tapi boleh dibaiki lagi lah. Lepas tu kita punya subjek ni identify and estimate. Okay. So, macam mana kita nak dapatkan dia punya full mathematical model?
Tu double click dekat warna merah tu. 223 tu.
Okay, double click. So, kita dapat polynomial A. Ni dia. Power of 2. Polynomial B. Power of 4. Two poles and one zeros. Check the FPE and MSE. Nanti awak tak nampak, minta maaf. Okay, tak share. Dia banyak window MATLAB ni. Nampak, mesti nampak ya kan? Nampak tak?
Nampak.
Nanti assignment check FPE tu zero tak, MSE tu zero tak. 0.00 tu kira zero lah. Jadi dia zero error. Dan kita tengok dia punya ni apa nama ni, itu dia punya model dan dia punya error, dan kita nak tengok dia punya mapping dia. Okay, mapping dia, so kita activate ni 441, kita activate. Okay, klik kat situ dia bool kan, bila bool dia activate, kita tengok 0 poles and 0 mapping dia, 4 poles 3 zeros. Okay, saya tengok sini, ni dia, nampak tak? Nampak
prof, nampak.
Jadi dekat mapping ni dia ada apa nama ni, kita kena letak grid. Tu grid dia lah. Okay. Dan kita kena letak unit circle. Bulatan bulat tu unit circle kan. Positive one, negative one, negative one, positive one. Umar, komen sikit Umar. Mapping ni. From the poles and zero map, koma.
Yes, saya doktor.
Buat ayat sikit. From the poles and zero map.
From the poles and zero map.
How many zeros?
Zeros ada 1, 2, 3, 4. Sorry, zero ada 3. Sorry.
3 je. Kemudian poles ada?
Poles ada 1, 2, 3. 4.
Okay. Macam mana kita nak dapatkan value dia tu?
Itu saya tak sure.
Tak sure eh? Siapa tahu macam mana nak dapatkan value dia tu? Siapa tahu? Kita deactivate Zoom ni. Kan? Ni Zoom kan?
Deactivate
dia. Deactivate. Jadi dia tak ada lah kan? Dan kita
okay. Pilih
ni. Nampak? Kita pakai mouse. Mouse ni kan? Nampak? Mouse. Dia ada left click dengan right click kan? Jadi kita pergi dekat left click. Nampak tu?
Nampak bro.
Jadi dia X dengan Y. Okay. Pada 0.76657. Ni nombor kompleks kan?
Nombor betul. Kompleks
ni. Dia pasangan dia yang ni. Umar, pasangan dia yang ni.
Betul.
Ini adalah minus 0.7657 plus minus plus minus 6.9.
6.906.
Dia adalah complex conjugate. Lepas tu dia ada dua tu. Ni yang ni, dia single. Why dia kosong? Dia tak ada imaginary. Jadi dia adalah real pada minus 0.8775. Yang ini, selain daripada pakai calculator, awak boleh pakai komputer dengan scanning lah macam ni. Tapi awak kena deactivate zoom tu dulu. Ini berapa? Pulse dia. Minus
0.4297.
Ya, yeah. Yang ni
0.7444.
Yang ini, yang ini ada, dia ada apa nama ni? Dia adalah complex number ni. Dia ada dua sini, ada complex ni. Nampak tak? Dia macam satu, dia adalah minus 0.4051 plus minus J 0.0538. Ini ada dua ni sebenarnya. Complex conjugate poles. Yang ini complex conjugate zeros. Okay. Ada dua value. Okay. Nampak tak? Tengok ni eh. Ni dia punya Y dia negatif kan? Real dia positif. Y dia negatif. Okay. Yang ini. Nampak? Dia punya X adalah positif, Y dia adalah positif. Jadi dia adalah plus minus. Cuma dia tak boleh tunjuk sebab dia rapat. Jadi dia macam overlap. Nampak macam overlap. Tapi sebenarnya dia tak overlap. Eh? Macam tu. Boleh. Analisis macam tu. Awak kena cerita. Eh? Jangan tunjuk je mapping dalam assignment. Tak ada cerita. Jadi tak syok lah. Kan? Macam tu. Okay. So itu adalah 0 and 4. Sama lah dengan yang ni juga. Kita deactivate yang ni, kita 331 pun sama. Okay, saya share. Okay, nampak ni? Fariha, a few words please.
Ya, doktor, nampak.
A few words, comment.
So, dari graf ni ada dua zeros.
Pole and zero mapping. Bukan graph, pole and zero mapping.
From the zero and poles mapping, ada dua zeros and tiga poles.
Okay. What does it mean? All poles inside inner circle, what does it mean?
Poles ni dekat dalam circle means dia stable.
System stable. And then, dua zeros outside inner circle?
Dua zeros yang outside inner circle ni, dia
non-minimum phase model. Okay, macam mana saya nak dapat nilai dia ni? Nak dapat nilai pulse dengan zeros ni? Pergi kepada style. Kan? Deactivate zoom. Okay. Dia ambil mouse. Klik dekat sini. Okay. Nampak?
Nampak.
Wah, boleh buat eh? Nanti boleh buat tak?
Wah, boleh.
Kalau tak tahu, tanya kawan-kawan yang tahu. Okay? Right. Okay, macam tu. Bagus. Kemudian kita pergi pada yang terakhir, which is 223. Okay, jadi. Kita. Stop share dulu. Okay, deactivate yang ni. So, 223. Pulse and zero mapping. Dia adalah yang paling mudah. Which is this one. Okay, so saya minta siapa lah tadi. Berapa orang kelas ni? Sibananta sudah, Zul sudah, Fariza sudah, Umar sudah, Daniel sudah. Itu je. Tak ramai yang datang hari ni. Tujuh orang. Zul Atfi sampai dua eh? On.
Saya guna dua device sebab mic saya problem.
Ini betul kau ni. Jadi yang ni saya komen lah. Okay. Jadi saya punya komen adalah, cuba saya tengok awak dengar saya punya ayat from the poles and zero mapping shown, okay, depicted in the figure, it is observed that there are two poles and one zero. All right. Two poles are located inside the unit circle. Ni unit circle. Eh? And one zeros also located in the unit circle. So this means that the system is stable due to the fact that all poles inside unit circles, and the system is a minimum phase model due to the fact that poles are inside the unit circle. Okay. And the system, the value of the system is, the pole's value is minus 0.6872, and the first pole is positive 0.5359, and the second pole is 0.7422. Okay. Okay, so kalau kita nak lihat ketiga-tiganya dalam satu graf yang sama, kita activate yang ni, kita activate yang ni, dan kita tengok model outputnya. Okay, so model outputnya adalah seperti yang ditunjukkan. So kita ada empat line, okay, ada empat line, empat warna. Black as usual is the real data. Blue estimated ARX 441 with 89.61%. Red is estimate ARX model 223 with 89.03%. Green is the estimate ARX 331 with 88.86%. Okay. So, nampaknya performance ni better. Jadi, kalau kita lihat di sini, kita tak ada idea. Okay. So, kita macam blur-blur kan. Apa model structure yang kita nak pakai. Okay. So, kita deactivate yang ni, deactivate yang ni, deactivate yang ni. Kita pergi pada estimate dan kita suruh dia quick start. Quick start ni dia carikan untuk kita. Dia carikan model tu untuk kita. So saya press quick start. So dia bagilah beberapa tu. Okay. Nampak? Dia kira. Banyak tu. Nampak? Sudah. Jom pergi pada sini. Okay, share. Okay. Stop share. Pergi pada sini. So, dicadangkan. Yang tadi ni, 441, 331, 223 yang kita cadangkan kan. Polinomial kita kan. Tapi dalam quick start, dia bagi impulse. Dia bagi SPED, dia bagi ARX QS dan N4S3. Okay. So, cuba kita lihat satu-satu model outputnya, impulse. Okay. Impulse, maknanya dia pakai impulse. 89.03%. Okay. Model impulse. Dia denyut lah. Isyarat dia denyut. Kemudian kita pergi pada second tu, SPED. Okay. Okay, itu SPED model. Okay, so dia tak bagi apa-apa pun. Okay, itu yang saya tak berapa suka pakai quick start ni. Okay, terusnya adalah kita tengok pada pada ni ARX QS. Okay, model apunya 89.44. Okay. Okay, 89.44. Dia ARX juga tapi dia pakai QS. I'm not sure dia pakai apa sebenarnya ni. Okay. Sebab tak semua model yang saya ajar di sini. Dan yang terakhir adalah N4S3. Okay. N4S3 model punya adalah 89.5. Lebih kurang sama lah. Macam 331, 441. Jadi nanti balik awak try, cuba dapatkan 100%. Kalau awak dapat 100%, above 90%. 90 ke atas lah kalau dapat. Awak beritahu saya. Boleh? Awak direct message pada saya. Cik, saya dapat best fit 90% dengan model structure awak lah. Jadi saya berhenti sampai sini. dan saya beri laluan pada awaklah untuk study for test tomorrow. Okay, kita ada lecture besok pada pukul pukul 2 petang. Kita start besok pukul 2 petang dengan lecture chapter 5C. Okay, kita akan lihat satu case lagi, iaitu hydraulic actuator. Then kita akan end up with the test 2. Yeah. So balik ni, try balik yang saya ajar tadi, chapter 4 tu, simple least square dengan generalized least square untuk tomorrow test 2. Any question? Ada soalan?
Hello, doktor nak tanya. Yang untuk ARX tu, dia yang delay tu memang at least kena satu, tak boleh kosong?
At least satu, sebab satu tolak satu jadi kosong.
Oh.
At least satu, mesti ada tulis satu lah. Jadi biasa kalau macam heater ni, pemanas ni kan, hair dryer ke berbenda ke, hair tumble dryer, baju lah sebagainya, dia tak boleh terus sampai pada temperature yang kita nak. Terus daripada zero terus jadi 40 Celsius kan, dia gradual naik kan. Dia tak boleh terus jadi. Dia tak macam DC motor, tekan switch terus pusing. Dia tak macam tu. Dia ada time delay dia. Time delay dia ada untuk dia start jadi panas, dia gradual naik lah. Dalam heating system mesti ada time delay. Tapi kalau dalam motor tak ada, usually tak ada motor. Tapi orang letak juga sebagai satu lah. Jadi satu tolak satu tu maknanya ada time delay. Tengok data lah. Sebenarnya kena tengok data. Tapi kalau RLC, RLC rasanya tak ada. Orang letak satu pun okey.
Alright,
ada soalan?
Doktor, yang untuk assignment ARX model tu, kita nak dapatkan dia punya pole zero and time delay tu, kita try and error ke?
Pakai lah. Macam mana tu? 2-2-1 ke, ataupun 3-3-1 ke, 3-2-1 ke, 3-1-1 ke. Sebab dia kalau derive transfer function tu, dia confirm ada dua poles kan? Confirm kan dia ada dua poles. Jadi yang zeros tu kalau ada dalam transfer function awak, maknanya awak kena masukkan lah. Awak kena try around lah.
Okay, faham betul.
Try around dan dapatkan jawapan. Jadi kalau tak ada soalan, saya bagi masa pada awak lah untuk belajar untuk besok. Mungkin awak sibuk kerja dan memerlukan masa untuk study. Cuba latihan yang saya bagi tu. Mana tahu mudah-mudahan boleh jawab untuk test 2 besok. Okey. Kita jumpa besok pukul 2. Okey, insyaAllah.
Okey, Prof. InsyaAllah.
Okay, besok pukul 2. Study dulu. Nanti saya share YouTube tu.